the situation or the case of making the da'wah. وَأَنَّهُ لَمَّا قَامَ عَبِدُ اللَّهِ يَدْعُوهُ كَانُوا يَكُونُونَ عَلَيْهِ لِبَدًا. You know the story when Prophet Muhammad ﷺ met al-jinn in the when he was coming back from Al-Ta'if to Mecca, and Allah sent some jinn to meet our Prophet ﷺ and to hear the Quran from him. And they, when they heard the Quran from Prophet Muhammad ﷺ, they gathered themselves together and they surrounded Prophet Muhammad ﷺ just to hear the Quran from the Prophet ﷺ. That was one of the greatest positions for Prophet Muhammad ﷺ. At this moment, he was a prophet, not to humankind, but to the jinn as well. And that was the first meeting for him to meet al-jinn and to know, to practice his role as a prophet to al-jinn, al-thaqalayn. That was the first meeting with al-jinn when he read al-Qur'an, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, recited al-Qur'an to them. At this position, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala described his prophet, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, وَأَنَّهُ لَمَّا قَامَ عَبِدُ اللَّهِ. When the servant of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala stood up, read Quran, invited them to Allah, كَانُوا يَكُونُونَ عَلَيْهِ لِبَدًا. And that was another position or another case for which you can understand that the best title and the best condition for the Muslims and the believers is really to be one of the servants of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to serve His deen and to serve His order on earth. And then, if a salah and a ruku' and a sujood and all of that is just part of our ibadah, worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, so how we can practice al ibadah, the real meaning of al ibadah, this big and huge order to practice ibadah for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. As our Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, قُلْ إِنَّمَا أُمِرْتُ أَنْ أَعْبُدَ رَبَّ هَذِهِ الْبَلْدَةِ الَّذِي حَرَّمَهَا وَلَهُ كُلُّ شَيْءٍ. To know that this is the spirit of our religion and this is really the message that we have to believe in. Worshiping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it doesn't depend on wherever you are or whenever you are or whatever you do. But it is based on what I am doing is for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and based on His Sharia. Very simple and very easy. In Islam, we do not know that there is a specific place in which you worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We do not know that in Islam. In Islam, we do not know that there is a specific time to worship Allah azza wa jalla. No, there is no time. There is no place for ibadah in Islam. And there is no specific act of worship, just if you do it, you worship Allah. No. But anything you do to please Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and not against the foundations of our religion, you do it for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to please Allah, to earn His pleasure, you are worshipping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Anything you do. And that doesn't require for us to be in the masjid, so I'm going to the masjid to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. No, you are going to the masjid to practice really a form of ibadah, a form of worship, a form which is a salah with a jama'ah. But still, you can practice al-ibadah outside the masjid. You can practice al-ibadah even with your children in your home. You can practice al-ibadah when just you park your car, how you do it, how you park your car, following the rules of the organization, that you belong to, or the society, you practice the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in all different circumstances, all different situations, all different cases. There is no specific time, there is no specific place, there is no specific action that if you do it, you worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But you can be really worshiper of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala any time and any place you are there. That's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala didn't accept from some people who were thinking just when they are in Mecca and Mukarrama, they are serving the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala at Kaaba. They are really taking care of a hujjaj, أجعلتم سقاية الحاج وعمارة المسجد الحرام كمن آمن بالله واليوم الآخر وجاهد في سبيل الله لا يستوون عند الله. They are not equal. Those who think that they are serving the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and those who are practicing the real Islam, making jihad for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, practicing the inclusive and the comprehensive meaning of ibadah in Islam. They are not equal. And that's why Allah says, لَيْسَ الْبِرَّ أَنْ تُوَلُّ وُجُوهَكُمْ قِبَلَ الْمَشْرِقِ وَالْمَغْرِبِ. لَيْسَ الْبِرَّ, it's not the only righteousness. Those who face or turn their faces toward the east or the west, Kaaba or Mecca or here or there, it's not a big issue. But then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talks about وَلَكِنَّ الْبِرَّ مَنْ آمَنَ بِاللَّهِ وَالْيَوْمِ الْآخِرِ وَالْمَلَائِكَةِ وَالْكِتَابِ وَالنَّبِيِّينَ. And this is what we call it, our Islamic creed, part of al-ibadah. وَآتَ الْمَالَ عَلَى حُبِّهِ ذَوِي الْقُرْبَى وَالْيَتَامَى وَالْمَسَاكِينَ وَابْنِ السَّبِيلِ. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talks about how we can look at the rest of the creations of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala being nice and kind and giving to all of those people. Okay? And then about some characteristics. وَالصَّابِرِينَ فِي الْبَأْسَاءِ وَالضَّرَّاءِ وَحِينَ الْبَأْسِ أُولَئِكَ الَّذِينَ صَبَرُوا وَأُولَئِكَ هُمُ الْمُتَّقُونَ. Allah doesn't talk about facing your face or turning your face toward a specific point. And this is the only way to practice ibadah. No, it's not right. But you have to practice the whole religion. The everything about Islam. Everything about the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's why in Islam, also we read in Surah Al-Kahf, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, فَمَنْ كَانَ يَرْجُوا لِقَاءَ رَبِّهِ فَلْيَعْمَلْ عَمَلًا صَالِحًا وَلَا يُشْرِكُ بِعِبَادَةِ رَبِّهِ أَحْدًا. That whoever desires or is looking for the meeting of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, being with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and honored with this meeting in the day of judgment when he meets Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, let him do good deeds. And there is no specific good deeds here. فَلْيَعْمَلْ عَمَلًا صَالِحًا. General, but should be good deeds. And that's what we'll discuss at the third, actually, commandments in this verse of Abu Khalif. Good deeds. And that good deeds should be just for Allah. Do not associate anyone with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When you practice these good deeds, do it for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Here, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala doesn't talk about practicing a salah or giving a zakah or anything about our Islamic common obligations that we, or rituals that we practice every day or every month or every year. But Allah talks about amal and salih, general good deeds, righteous deeds. But should be for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Why? Because the one who practices these general good deeds will not do it unless he practices Islamic obligations. Because this is a level. You cannot, for example, expect that someone who's praying a sunnah in the masjid while he did not practice or perform salat al-fariq, or one giving what you call it optional charity while he does not give a zakat, the obligatory charity for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So if an Islam talks here about the one who desires the meeting of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala should do good deeds, general good deeds, it means that he first would practice and perform the obligatory actions and sins that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala repeated in the Quran, and then you will do these general and common good deeds among the society. This is a level, and you can reach it unless you finish the first one. فَمَنْ كَانَ يَرْجُوا لِقَاءَ رَبِّهِ فَلْيَعْمَلْ عَمَلًا صَالِحًا وَلَا يُشْرِكْ بِعِبَادَةِ رَبِّهِ أَحَدًا. Our Prophet sallallahu alaihi gave a very good example for this ibadah, general ibadah that we are talking about today, not just the salah and zakah. He said, الإيمان بضعٌ وسبعون أو بضعٌ وستون شعبة أعلاها لا إله إلا الله وأدناها إماطة الأذى عن الطريق. That the iman is made up about 70 and some branches, shu'bah. And the highest shu'bah or branch of this iman is la ilaha illallah, of course. This is the highest thing. This is the key to enter the circle of al-iman. And the lowest thing is to remove bad things and the evil things and the harmful things from the way of iman. And this is the lowest thing. But you see the highest la ilaha illallah, and then you do it. Other things. Removing bad things from the way of people. The harmful things. Protecting the others. Not just that, but our Prophet gave another example that when you meet, you receive your brother with a good smile, that's considered as a form of ibadah, as a charity. But al-kalima al-tayyiba sadaqa, good words and nice words are considered in Islam actually as a charity, as a form of ibadah. And this is Islam. This is our Islam. This is the ibadah that we really need to practice. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَعْبُدُوا رَبَّكُمْ وَعْبُدُوا رَبَّكُمْ. And then our Prophet mentioned many, many different examples for these forms of ibadah. But as I mentioned, they are not actually limited to what our Prophet mentioned. But they are very inclusive, that can include everything, every good thing, every righteous thing that we do for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. طلب العلم, for example, seeking the knowledge is ibadah for the sake of Allah. As our Prophet says, طلب العلم فريضة على كل مسلم ومسلم. And there is something very beautiful saying that قيام or طلب العلم ساعة خير من صلاة 70 سنة نافلة, of course. That seeking the knowledge just for 1 hour is better than worshipping or performing the salah 70 years. Salah is not the obligatory prayer, of course, but it's the optional prayer, like Qiyam al-Layl, for example. And as-Saliheen, for example, or our scholars, used to make Qiyam al-Layl not through as-Salah, praying, but through reading al-Qur'an or reading, writing their knowledge. For others actually to get benefit from. And that's why in our Quran we do not understand that Qiyam al-Layl means just praying Salatul Layl. This is a common understanding, that when we say I would like to make Qiyam al-Layl, means what? I will pray to Raka'ah or 4 Raka'ah. No. If Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants from us really to practice Qiyam al-Layl just by performing 2 raka'ah or 4 raka'ah, Allah will say, just Salatul Layl. Go and pray. But Qiyam al-Layl means that you are not sleeping, you are working, you are awake. And Qiyam means I'm standing. The real meaning in Arabic, Qama, ma'ana, he stands up. Stands up for a task, for something to perform. Either Salah, either studying, but should be good deeds for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Something good you do. Thinking about what I will do next day, preparing yourself for your work for next day. If you stand up and woke up actually just to do that for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and to be in a better position to serve the community, to serve the humankind, you are worshipping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the best time of worship, which is al-layl, the night. So Qiyam al-Layl in Islam doesn't mean just a Salat al-Layl, but it means everything you do in this specific time for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and for the benefit of human beings. You see, this is the sweetness of Islam, the sweetness of the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's why some of the big scholars and jurists used to prefer actually not to fast. Why? Because we're talking about the optional fasting. Why? Because he said that I prefer just to spend my time and my effort in seeking knowledge over fasting. Because he thought, for example, maybe that if he fasts, that will not give him a chance or the energy just to collect knowledge and seek knowledge sufficiently. So he preferred seeking knowledge over fasting Mondays or Thursdays or optional fasting. And this is something we have really to understand and we have to practice in our life. وَعْبُدُوا رَبَّكُمْ. And this is the meaning of ibadah.
the real meaning of ibadah that we have to practice in our life. And then we'll move here to another thing which is important at the same time, that if Allah says, وَفْعَلُوا الْخَيْرَ لَعَلَّكُمْ تُفْلِحُونَ, here we have اعْبُدُوا رَبَّكُمْ, and we mentioned that this is a comprehensive meaning. If anything you do for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is to his sharia and not against his will. And then Allah says, وَفْعَلُوا الْخَيْرَ, and اِفْعَلُوا الْخَيْرَ, do good deeds. What does it mean? If وَعْبُدُوا رَبَّكُمْ means everything you do for the sake of Allah. So what Allah here is ordering us, or the believers actually, to do good deeds as well. If these good deeds are part actually of worshipping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, so that also can give us a very great reflection and indication that we have to understand about our religion. That اعبدوا ربكم here is related actually to the things that are mentioned in the Quran and the Sunnah of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. You have a clear evidence in the Quran to do it. Either they are optional or they are obligatory. But they are mentioned in the Quran al-Kareem and the Sunnah of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And if عَدُوا الْخَيْرِ, all good things that are not mentioned in the Quran and the Sunnah of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and you can see among human beings, can be also a part of our religion. Because they are good deeds. They are common good that we have to follow. That's why Allah says, وَفْعَلُوا الْخَيْرِ. Any good deeds you meet and you face and you watch here and you observe there and you hear about it there, try to do it for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Either it comes from Muslim or from non-Muslims. But the most important condition that you make good deeds for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Of course, if Allah doesn't say وَفْعَلُوا الْخَيْرِ after وَعْبُدُوا رَبَّكُمْ, we'll have the same meaning and understanding from وَعْبُدُوا رَبَّكُمْ. But if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says وَفْعَلُوا الْخَيْرِ after وَعْبُدُوا رَبَّكُمْ, here وَفْعَلُوا الْخَيْرِ has a different meaning. Which is all good deeds that are not mentioned in the Quran directly or in the Sunnah of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam clearly, that also should be a part of our religion. That's why الْحِكْمَةُ ضَالَّةُ الْمُؤْمِنِ أَيْنَمَا وَجَدَاكَ وَأَحَقُّ النَّاسِ حِكْمَةُ, any wisdom, any good deeds or common good belong to the believers. Either it is in Islamic society or non-Muslim society. Muslim society or Muslim traditions or other traditions. I'm looking to be good. And so I will follow and everything good are related to Quran as well. And can be considered as a form of ibadah. Not just that, but is one of our commandments that we have to do. That's why our Prophet Muhammad says, خَيْرُ النَّاسِ أَنْفَعُهُ النَّاسِ. The best of human beings is the one who is the most beneficial to all human beings. Doing anything good for people, وَفْعَلُوا خَيْرُ, any good things you do, go ahead and do it. Some people, some Muslims will say, oh, we cannot be really involved in these actions because you know that Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam never being involved in doing an action. For example, sitting with non-Muslims in different places, our Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam didn't practice that in his life, sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Going into the church or the places of worship, other people who are worshiping something to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, our Prophet did not do that. Yes, what is the intention? Is it good deed or not? You are looking for Allah to express religion. You have a very golden rule and wisdom you have to follow. Is it good? Yes, it's good. Is it against Allah, his rule? Or his rule? No, go ahead and do it. With this intention, you will get the reward. You will be rewarded, inshaAllah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And you will be considered that you are the one who practices Islam clearly and correctly. Not just that, but as Allah says, successfully. That's what we need to understand. If so, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in this verse is ordering us to perform ruku' and sujood. And ruku' and sujood here is very important to take us to those two levels. عبادة أم فعل الخلق. To worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala correctly and worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala based on what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has ordered us to do, you have to practice three ruku' and sujood. We know that we have many people, non-Muslims or even Muslims who are not practicing Islam completely, they are doing great jobs in different areas, but they are not practicing ruku' and sujood. Yes, they are, I can't say that those are a people of good deeds, but I cannot say that they are worshipping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Why? Because you have first to start with a ruku' and sujood. And that will take your ibadah to the level that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accepts, and the level that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will be pleased with. Without practicing ruku' and sujood, you are a good person, of course. I cannot say not. While you are practicing good things, you are a good person. And you are one of good people who are doing great things for humanity. But to be from the worshippers of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you need to practice first a ruku' and a sujood. And for your ibadah and doing good deeds in general, you really need to nourish your heart always. To nourish your heart in a very frequent ways and styles like a salah. So that will take you, inshaAllah, to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala more and more. And so, for those who understand the Quran and worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala based on the clear orders or instructions from Quran al-Kareem, if they do that really based on the correct understanding of Al-Quran, that will lead them to be part of participating in general and common good deeds in society. The one who says that I cannot really practice or be part of these good deeds with non-Muslims or with some people in here or there, he needs to go back to practice and to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala based on the verses and the rules of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Once he reaches this level, he will be capable, inshallah, to participate with others in really spreading good deeds among the humankind in this life. But this is actually something we hope that we gain from this verse and to practice, inshallah, this week. And still, we have the reward that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has promised us to gain from this verse if we fulfill those three things, ruku' and sujood, ibadah, fi'l and khayr, which is la'allakum tuflihun. So how can we be successful? How we should consider ourselves that we are really successful people, who can consider ourselves as successful people. That we'll talk about inshallah next time, and then we'll move to the next verse, which is talking about more things that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is ordering the believers to fulfill in order really to complete the real ibadah, the real worship, and the real communication or connection with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I'll stop here, inshallah, to take some reflection or reflections from you, comments, or even you have questions. Please feel free, inshallah, to participate.
Assalamu alaikum. I didn't understand about fa'alu khayr, that part, because some culture or some area in the world, Muslim, like maybe they do Maulid Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and they can include.